Hi Mona,
हेलो जी,
how are you? सत श्री अकाल.
आई एम गुड. सत श्री अकाल, हाउ आर यू?
Very well, thank you. I've heard you've had a very long day and a tiring one too. Long and tiring day.
Yes, I've had a long day. I've been shooting, and now since Bombay is under curfew after 8 p.m., so just got back home.
Okay, so I hope the conversation will not be tiring. I just hope that I can make it more interesting.
Oh yes, I'm sure about that.
So, Mona, how do you deal with this? One long, tiring day, and suddenly you have to pump up energy in yourself, and then you have to talk about your experiences, and in goes ears again. So, how do you deal with it? Do you have a cup shot of coffee, or how do you do it? Is the cha works for you?
Work always is exciting. I'm always very passionate about going on set and working and learning something new. And when you have an interview lined up, you've got to be fresh. So this is something I really enjoy, and I'm sure you're going to make it pretty relaxed for me.
So, what are you shooting for at the moment?
I'm shooting for a web series about which I can't talk about right now, and it's a great role, something I've never played before.
That's lovely because you actually known for roles that people don't generally take up, but you experiment a lot ever since you've debuted, and
Yeah,
it's been
I'm
fun
glad that
watching
people
you.
give me the opportunity to, experiment and try to do something different.
Is it because actors like you, they can rely on, I mean, you can't do this with everybody. And you really don't get actors like you every day whom they can rely upon. मुझे पता है ते करे लेगी, so let her do what's wrong for you.
Thank you, Gurleen. Thank you so much. But see, the thing is, for me, I've always been the kind of person who loves challenges. I don't like to do the same thing again and again. It gets very boring.
Right.
So when you talk about TV shows also, beyond a point, it just gets very boring because you're playing the same character for many years, meeting the same people, same set. So it just gets monotonous. So for me, acting is all about experimenting, doing something that you're not, and challenging yourself. So I've been lucky enough to, get such roles.
Right. So, अच्छा मोनो, we have never seen you do roles जिथे तुसी वो heavy chunks of jewellery पाई हुई है, those typical long sindoos and everything. Did you ne never get such offers, or you purposely said, भाई ये वाला makeup मेरा नहीं करना?
मैं तो सब तो पहले यही वाले ऑफर मना कर दिया, देन लोगों को समझ आ गया कि भाई इन्हें नहीं करना है.
Any offer that you are sorry for कि यार नहीं मैंने कर लेना चाहिए सी, probably I just could not take it up that time.
नो, नॉट दैट आई कैन रिमेम्बर. नो, हले तो नहीं हुआ वो अपॉर्चुनिटी.
Right. So probably those opportunities don't even come your way. पता ही है कि जेड़ा इन्हें करना है वो ही आंदा है देखो, right?
Yeah, I think so.
Wonderful. Okay, so Mona, try this is a very repetitive question, but it's a must in every interview. So you debuted in 2003 with Jassi Jassi Koini, and you changed the game of TV altogether. TV soaps were no more the same, right? Even I remember, my heart was thumping when the moment you changed, transformed, and you came in front of the love of your life, and how things went. I still feel the emotion because it was so beautiful. But ever since, we haven't really got to see such kind of shows and the kind of characters that you've played. So there was also talks ki jassi jassi koi nahi nu revive karan di koshish kar rahe ne, or there was a season two that they were planning to do, and you were also talking about it. So did those plans ever happen, or they just couldn't do it?
The plans didn't materialize, but it would have been good agar jaise jaise koi nahi to aata. It would have been really exciting, but somehow things didn't work out. Yeah, but my first show being most memorable and most loved till date is a big honor. Yeah, I feel very blessed to be a part of that show.
So are you in touch? Because we recently saw you featuring on Kapil Sharma, but you were not with Apoorva. So do you guys are you guys still connected or not?
Apoorva and I are very much in touch. Gaurav and I, of course, are family. Dia Toni, I keep talking to every now and then. Rakshanda, I keep talking to. Rajesh Khera, the one who played Maddie, I'm
I
in
see
touch
Hanji
with.
Hanji. Right.
हाँ जी, मेरी जेडी बेबे हैगी उन्हां दे नाल भी गल हुंदी रहिंदी है, मेरी मम्मा दे नाल हुंदी है, सारे ब्याह च भी आए सीगे मेरे.
Very nice, very nice. I want to talk about your personal life because there's something very interesting that I want to ask you about that. But right now, let me
Sure.
stick on to your professional life. ठीक है. अच्छा मैं पूछना सीखा, बिकॉज आई हर्ड दैट यू वांट, यू वर एक्चुअली गोइंग टू बी एन एयर होस्टेस बिफोर यू बैग्ड
हाँ
सो व्हाट इफ यू वुड हैव टेकन दैट जॉब, यू नो, आफ्टर सो मेनी इयर्स, वेयर वुड यू हैव सीन योरसेल्फ?
You know, the thing is, I was at that point in life, you know, I was just 21 and my sister was telling me, ki tu karna ki hai? What about acting and all? Asi kisi nu nahi jaande, nobody from the family is in this field. How are you going to survive?
Right.
So I used to keep telling her that, you know, at least let me try. If I fail, I know that I tried. So
Right.
she's like, nahi, main na tera form fill karke bhej rahi hun for Singapore Airlines and you have to go.
Right.
So I said, "Acha, theek hai." You know, so I had no idea on a key form fill kita si, what all did she write. So when I went for my interview, they said, "Oh, you like to read and you like to do." I was like, yeah, okay." and somehow I cleared the interview. Somehow I passed all the tests. I got my visa.
Right.
And in 10 days, I was supposed to leave for Singapore. And you know, somehow I was not happy. I was not happy. I told my parents. I told my dad, I was like, Papa, minu try karan do. So he's like, what about your visa? I said, I'll go back and cancel. He's like, I don't want you to regret. I don't want you to, you know, make any choices about which you are not happy.
Right.
So you go, this is your life and we will support you. So bas unna hi sunna, you know, bahut hunda hai. And I came to Bombay, I cancelled my visa. I was, of course, feeling very bad. I was not sure ki life che hona ki again.
Right.
But I still struggled for 2 years after that.
I know.
And then I got the
Mumbai journey. I did have certain bits of that.
Yeah.
Amazing. Yeah. Amazing.
And then when we were shooting for Jassi, 6 months after that, we went to Singapore to shoot for Jassi and we flew in Singapore Airlines. Can you imagine? I was telling my parents, I was like, dekho, this is destiny.
I swear.
Yeah.
And destiny, I mean, destiny plays a very important role in, you know, did you ever believe in destiny before things started happening for you? I mean, or you just thought, ki nahi, sara kuch planned hota hai. Destiny doesn't happen.
See, earlier I used to think that, you know, we do make the choices. There is a free will. There are some tough decisions which we have to take, make.
Right.
But sometimes I just feel it is all pre-planned. You know, this had to happen. So it is happening.
Right.
Pata nahi, I really don't know. I think there is a mix of free will and destiny.
Right. Acha, there are a few questions that I want to ask you here. I read that you wanted to make movies. Are you still into that process?
Not movies right now, but I definitely am writing something for a web series.
Okay, so you're planning to make a web series?
I plan to, yes.
Okay, so any particular genre that you'd love to get into?
I want to get into more of, you know, real cinema, real stories, my experiences.
Okay.
Also, what is happening in India. You know, there are a few cases which are not addressed. So I want to write about those things.
So talking about this particular thing that you've just said, do you think people are very open to the kind of, you know, miseries that women undergo? Are they open to seeing that vulnerability with open eyes and, you know, open ears? Are they ready to listen to such topics? Do you think?
Yeah, I'm sure, you know, because I feel we underestimate the audience all the time. We feel ki ye nahi chalega. But why are we not making it even to try whether chalega ya nahi chalega? Then it's its own destiny, whether it'll work or not. But at least you try to make something like that.
Right.
There are people making amazing movies on depression. Who knew that somebody would make a movie on that?
Right.
So people are watching, you know, people are appreciating new kind of cinema stories. So I think producers, writers should dare to write now, because now is the time to do it, to explore, to experiment.
So in a way, did Corona also prove to be a boon for people like, you know, who are more into creative content rather than the commercial content, because people have started consuming a lot of OTT content, you know, that's very realistic.
Exactly. And you see, this is the kind of content that we all have been waiting for. We've been wanting to watch such things.
True.
And during lockdown, we watched so many such shows and movies and everybody appreciated it. So why not make it now?
Right. So tell me about your shows. I mean, all the shows that you've been doing, the characters have been very strong-headed. Are you a strong-headed person in real life as well?
If I make up my mind to do something, then I go all out. I go after it. So
and
yes, when it comes to that, yes.
is there something very particular that you have to do before you start, you know, grabbing the essence of the character that you will be portraying on screen?
So, you know, normally what happens is, which is a very good thing with OTT platform, we get the bound script in hand, which never happens in TV. You know, when you're about to start a TV show, you hardly get 2 episodes to read and that's it. And then as the TRP comes, you know, then they start writing along. But when it comes to OTT, you have all the 8 and 10 episodes. How many episodes are there? You have it with you. Right. Then you have workshops with all the actors, with the director, with the creative person, with the writer. So right. you're following one vision, right. you know, and I'm a very instinctive actor. I am a director's actor. Of course, I have my inputs, but I go with my gut. So when it comes to preparation, I do read about the character a lot and I also observe people. So it helps me.
Right. So I said there's a lot of successful TV celebrities who are like, who don't really like doing TV anymore because they say, yaar, pata nahi chalta, bada khajal hunda banda, and there's a lot of bad shooting schedules and everything. Are you one of those people as well?
You know, OTT has spoiled me now. So after doing so many shows on the web, I feel TV is getting boring. It's getting monotonous. People are not writing good stuff. It's just getting very mediocre. So right now, I want to stay away, and it's a cautious choice.
So, did you ever try playing the mythological series
wale
characters?
No, mere ko nahi hoga. I'm such a Punjaban. I will never say, putra, ye tumhari dharti hai. Never.
That's experimentation as well. Did you never try it in theater as well?
I don't think I'm cut out for that. I won't be able to. Ye agar kisi ne challenge kita to main kar lungi. But,
right. But you otherwise, I don't like to.
Yeah, exactly. I can't wear those mukuts and stand and say potato.
With those rays coming out, you know.
Rays coming out. Yeah.
Okay, so you've been a part of the advertising world as well. You've advertised, yes. You've been the brand ambassador for some very big brands. So how is life as, you know, in this sector versus the sector that you're in right now? And is it for strugglers? Or do you think, nahin, theek hai, wo bhi achha kam hai ga? I love ads.
Initially when I wanted to get into acting, I was only auditioning for ads. I did not meet anybody from the film industry because I wasn't looking that way. So I wanted to wanted to be a part of fashion shows. I wanted to be a part of commercials, right. and do some good TV serials, right. and you know, when I was in school, I used to watch Diya Tony's Banegi Apni Baat. And tab se mere man mein tha that, you know, I hope I meet these makers someday and I work with them. But universe had already planned it, you know, in such a way. But ads teach you a lot, you know. Ads are shorter. You got to sell the product in exactly 20 to 25 seconds. And you need to get the expressions right. It is challenging, but it is a lot of fun. So people who want to pursue, they should start with, you know, getting into advertisements.
So have you seen a change in the way people are making ads these days? They're becoming more socially responsible?
Yes, they are. In fact, during lockdown, there were a lot of ads which I shot myself at home. And they wanted that kind of an ad because it becomes a testimony for them. That, achha bhaiya, ye aise ghar pe hai and baithe hue and she's talking about this brand. And oh yes, she must be using it because she's in her own comfort zone.
Right.
So these are the kind of new concepts that people are coming up with now.
Perfect, perfect. So talking about being at home and using the kind of brands, tell me about it. What is your favorite styling, you know, what fashion statement that you love to be comfortable in, you love wearing? Except for the
at home?
At home and otherwise, like something that gives you comfort.
So I'm all for comfort. Anything that is comforting for fabric and even the style, I go for it. I like everything that is loose. And when I'm shooting, my designers go crazy. They're like, "Arre, ma'am, ye bahut bada size hai. Itna bada size mat pehno." I'm like, "Nahi, mujhe loose chahiye."
So you're one of those people more into
Lakhnavi
chappels than heels?
I'm completely into Lakhnavis and Kolhapuri chappels, jeans and kurta. I'm completely into that. Nowadays, I've been wearing a lot of saris. I picked up a lot of cotton saris and I'm loving wearing that.
Is it the South effect in your life?
हाँ जी, आई थिंक इट इज द साउथ इफेक्ट.
अच्छा, कमिंग टू योर पर्सनल लाइफ मोना, टेल मी, यू नो देयर इज दिस थिंग अबाउट पंजाबीज, यू नो, सो व्हेन यू टॉक टू योर पेरेंट्स अबाउट इट, यू सेड मैं साउथ दे मुंडे दे नाल ब्याह करान लगी हां, व्हाट वाज द रिएक्शन ऑफ द फैमिली, द टिपिकल पंजाबी रिएक्शन, टेल मी अबाउट इट.
It was a mix of emotions, you know. My mother was like, "Acha, really? Te ki karta hai munda? Kithon aayega?" I said, "I'm getting him home. You meet him." So he, of course, came home, and you know, my husband is well traveled. Most of his friends are also from the army,
right.
So he knew how we are, and my parents instantly liked him. And then, of course, we met his parents. They're very sweet, simple people. So my mother was like, "Tu inaad naal khush rahegi, tu chinta na kar." I was like, "Hanji." Yeah.
So in the wedding, was there anything like, you know, intercaste? The inter, jehde south north wali weddings hundi hai na, de vich te goof ups bhi bade hunde hai. Tade vyah koi goof ups, koi aise memorable moments, some comedy things happening which you still remember?
Actually, ki hoya na, mera bada dil sega ki gurdwara che wedding kariye apan. But intercaste chakkar che na, I don't know, it did not happen.
Okay.
They said ki agar munda sardar hai te kudi tamilian hai te chal jaoga. But it cannot happen the other way around, and I was very upset.
Gurdwara people said this to you?
Yeah, I wanted an Ankaraj, and it did not happen.
Okay.
So then we went to the army club, and we hired this place, and we did the normal Arya Samaj wedding. So there was no Tamilian wedding or no Punjabi wedding. So there was no confusion at all.
But we did see the gorgeous bride dance to Punjabi songs.
Oh, that hona hi si na, fir DJ ta apna hi si.
Right. So tell me about Sham a little bit. You know, ek te hunda na sada lifestyle hunda hai. Typical Punjabi lifestyle. We're very cool-headed people at home, you know. Sofa te latta chada ke aram na baithna and sipping our
हार्ड कोर पंजाबी. The kind he has, you know, mostly lived in Delhi and Lucknow.
Okay.
All his friends are Sardars and Punjabis.
Oh.
My mother-in-law speaks better Punjabi than anybody I know around. Yes.
Okay.
Te jad lohri aan wali sigi te meri mother-in-law Punjabi che gaane gaandi pe si. Oh, sundar mundri hoye. Ab ise kare. So they are half Punjabis, and there's nothing that I feel ki are ye match nahi ho raha ya wo match nahi ho raha.
Yeah.
We are pretty similar. It's just that he's a coffee lover and I'm a tea lover.
You're a tea lover. Oh, thank God. Okay. In the 2006 interview, once you had said that you have this, you know, fascination to get married to Abhishek Bachchan. And, you know, you like, you said in one of your interviews, I'll tell you which one.
When?
So, yeah, it was. And you'd confess that if he comes and proposes me someday, I would immediately say yes. So,
I must be in my 20s then.
Choices change with age.
I don't even remember. Yeah, choices change with age.
So, you are now shocked that you ever had that option in your mind?
Yeah, I am a little shocked.
All right. And in the same interview, you had mentioned that, you know, you like people who are tall, dark, and have a sense of humor.
Yes, yes.
Hana, so
I've always said that.
Yeah, so I could see Sham fitting very well into that, though he's not
very
that tall.
Well. Tall, dark, handsome.
Caring.
Very caring.
Very caring.
I'd say I am more caring than him for sure. He's a silent guy who cares silently. मतलब अगर कुछ खुला है तो वो फट से बंद कर देगा, knowing that I'm walking around and शायद मुझे लग जाए.
Those little gestures, huh?
Yeah.
So if you have to mark yourself as a perfect couple, would you mark yourself as 10 on 10 or there are certain places where you feel that we could
10 on 10 to kabhi hona bhi nahi chahiye. I think that's
right.
That's not perfect,
right.
Imperfections are always welcome there, so I think we are 7.5 on 10.
Still very nice, na? ਟੇਵੇ ਮਿਲਵਾਏ ਸੀਗੇ ਮਿਲਣ ਤੋਂ ਪਹਿਲਾਂ?
ਹਾਂਜੀ
ਮੈਂ ਕਿਹਾ ਟੇਵੇ ਮਿਲਵਾਏ ਸੀਗੇ ਵਿਆਹ ਤੋਂ ਪਹਿਲਾਂ?
ਕੁਛ ਨਹੀਂ ਮਿਲਵਾਇਆ ਆਪਾਂ।
ਆਲਰਾਈਟ ਫਾਈਨ। ਅੱਛਾ, ਨਾਓ ਇਟਸ ਅ ਲਿਟਲ ਥਿੰਗ ਫਰੋਮ ਦੀ ਹੈਡਲਾਈਨਸ ਦੈਟ ਯੂ ਮੇਡ ਇਨ ਦ ਰੀਸੈਂਟ ਪਾਸਟ। ਵੀ ਰੈਡ ਦੈਟ ਯੂ ਨੋ ਐਟ ਦੀ ਏਜ ਆਫ 34 ਯੂ ਫਰੋਜ਼ ਯੋਰ ਐਗਸ, ਸੇਇੰਗ ਦੈਟ ਨਾਓ ਆਈ ਐਮ ਫ੍ਰੀ ਟੂ ਟਰੈਵਲ ਦ ਵਰਲਡ। ਸੋ ਦੈਟ ਮੂਵ ਵਾਸ ਪ੍ਰੀਟੀ ਬੋਲਡ ਟੂ ਬੀ ਵੋਕਲ ਅਬਾਊਟ, ਯੂ ਨੋ। ਸੋ ਵਾਟ ਕਾਈਂਡ ਆਫ ਰਿਐਕਸ਼ਨਸ ਕੇਮ ਯੋਰ ਵੇ ਵੈਨ ਯੂ ਸੈਡ ਦੈਟ?
It was very welcoming. You see, times have changed now. All women are working and it is their choice whether they want to have a baby right now after marriage or not. Mm-hmm. It is our choice. Mm-hmm. You know, nobody can now force ki are bhai shaadi hogi aur bachcha kab kar rahe ho. So yes, when I was 34, I knew that I still have to work and I am not looking at just to get married because clock is ticking.
Right.
So I thought why not freeze my eggs? If I ever want to, you know, have a child, at least I won't worry about that.
Right.
And my parents also graciously accepted the whole idea and they said, why not go for it?
Hmm.
So I did. And there are a lot of women who I know have also done the same.
So are families okay with this? Both the families that you're not having kids?
Absolutely. Absolutely.
Great. Okay. So are they pumping in, you know, okay.
नहीं होते, वो लोग बोलते पे ना कि कोरोना चलता पे की टाइम आ गया, बच्चे की देखेंगे। And it's a fact. Just look at us. What has life come to now?
Exactly.
It is scary to have a child now. Imagine your baby with a mask who's not allowed to play or shake hands or hug people.
I swear. It's so scary, Anna. But life actually taught people a lot of other things as well, you know. So I think COVID has in a way proved to be a blessing for all of us to learn the lessons in life from the humanity, you know, was it pretty grievous.
Humanity, yes, but you know, it is still shocking that people have forgotten what we went through during lockdown.
That's true.
Nobody is wearing a mask, and if you tell them to wear, they stare back at you as if, you know, she's talking nonsense.
Please, we know what to do.
Haan. तो मतलब खुद को ही बचा के चलो, डोंट टेल अदर्स टू डू व्हाट दे शुड।
वंडरफुल। ओके सो मोना, ओके अ फ्यू अदर थिंग्स। ओके सो यू एंड गौरव, यू शेयर अ वेरी स्ट्रॉन्ग कनेक्शन, यू नो, एंड एवर सिंस यू गाइस मेट एट द ऑडिशन दैट आई नो दैट यू डिड, सो देयर वाज देयर एनी पॉइंट ऑफ टाइम इन योर लाइफ वेयर इन सम अदर मैन इन योर लाइफ फेल्ट अ लिटिल इनसिक्योर ऑफ द फ्रेंड दैट यू हैड इन योर लाइफ हु वाज सो क्लोज टू यू?
Not really, no.
Because no. It is actually very
It's a precondition. Main to apne pati nu vyah to pehle hi bolta thi, main kehti Gaurav is someone who is never getting out of my life. Main ke je kudkud kiti na ladai ho jani hai.
Chances of kudkud were there?
I don't know, but before it could happen, I just already, you know, announced it that he's never getting out of my life. He's family.
That, you know, it is still so beautiful over the years.
You know, we've matured together, we've grown up together, we've seen each other's ups and downs, we're there for each other. Even when we were, you know, single, he used to be there for me. If I was ill and my parents weren't around, he used to sit the night, all night, and do, you know, patiya and take care of me, and I've done the same for him. And if I am confused about something or if he's confused about, you know, some decision, we help each other out. Hmm. We know everything that is happening in each other's lives. Hmm. We are that open towards each other. And I think that is a bond which is absolutely priceless. And we don't judge each other. No matter what you do in life, even if you go and kill somebody, I'll still support Gaurav. You know, we are that for each other. So, ऐसे relationship ना ज़िंदगी में कभी बनते नहीं हैं. जो बनते हैं उनको हमेशा रखना चाहिए. So, Gaurav is that for me.
Right, and he's also one of those friends who says के तू bore हो रही है तो मत हो. And he.
yeah.
Wonderful. All right. Okay. So tell me about the things that you don't expect your partner to do when you're around. I mean, you don't expect Shyam to do particular things, certain things when you're around, especially when you're around.
Dirty the room. I have terrible OCD. So he makes sure that he doesn't litter around, you know, like shoes will be in place, shirt will be in place, bathroom will be intact because he knows I'm home.
All right. That's okay. So no towels on the bed and anything like that.
वो सब होता है व्हेन आई एम नॉट अराउंड, व्हेन आई एम आउट फॉर शूट देन तो घर पूरा बर्बाद है, बट द मिनट आई एम अबाउट टू कम बैक इट्स लाइक स्पिक एंड स्पैन. सो आई डोंट सरप्राइज चेक्स, आई डोंट टेल हिम दैट आई पैक्ड अप एंड आई कम होम अर्ली.
एंड व्हाट्स द रिएक्शन लाइक? इज इट इंस्टेंट?
लड़ाई लड़ाई लड़ाई
लड़ाई. ओह माय गॉड. डू यू गेट अलोंग विद हिज फ्रेंड्स आई मीन एज मच एज ही गेट्स अलोंग आई मीन ही इज अंडरस्टैंडिंग अबाउट योर्स?
Yeah, but you know, the most surprising thing is that we are mostly with my friends and he gets along with my friends more than his.
Really?
I love that.
So how often do you travel? I mean, Haleta nahi, but yeah.
No, we both have been traveling for work. We both have been traveling. We both have got our, you know, corona test done some 30-40 times. And what to do? Now work has
to...
मेरे तो नोज ही एकदम हो गया. We are very careful because my parents live next door and I you know have to see them every day. So we have been getting our tests done. We are not meeting people, not exposing ourselves outside. So we are careful.
So what is that thing about people, I mean especially fans that love you or people who adore you, that you know that surprises you sometimes when they meet you? Any certain incident that you still remember from a fan's point of view?
I'll tell you a funny incident which happens most of the time with me. So whenever I'm traveling or wherever I am and people spot me and they're like, especially women, they come up to me and they say, "Arey, aap to bade patle lag rahe ho screen pe, to bade mote ho." I'm like, "Oh God." It is so embarrassing. I'm like, "Achha bhai, thank you." I don't know if it's a compliment or what.
But you do, I mean, do you take care of your fitness very much?
Yes, I do. But, you know, like when we all were under lockdown and we weren't working, so I wasn't going crazy about fitness. I was eating everything. And I did put on a lot of weight. But when I knew ki acha ab kaam shuru ho raha hai, then I was back to my routine of eating on time, eating a little less healthy, no fried. So, yeah, like but right now I am sticking to that. I am a big time foodie and so is my husband. We love food.
So, okay, how about going under the knife to keep yourself up to date with the expectations on screen? How often do you do that? Do you do that?
What is that? Sorry?
Going under the knife, getting all those Botoxes and everything done.
See, it depends on person to person about as to how conscious you are about your face and the way you look. Right now, I feel everything is fine. Jay lage kuch latak lutak gaya hai, I don't know, I might give it a shot. I haven't thought about it.
So, but I mean, is it only because you're, I mean, aging lai ta nahi karde aajkal te kudiyan itthe vi tike lagwa rahi hunde na to
look? Nahi nahi, oh sab bada ganda hai, sari ikko jiyan dikhdiyan. I don't like that.
Yeah, so you choose the to look the way you are and you're comfortable.
I rather be me. Yeah,
great, fine. Okay, so last few questions that I'm going to ask you.
Anji.
What was the highest point of success that you've tasted till now?
Jesse,
I mean, when did you realize that you are very famous and it's a hit?
So, you know, when we were shooting for Jesse, I didn't know what was happening outside in the world because the channel guys had kept me hidden. And there were journalists who had challenged Sony that they will reveal my actual look, how I look without the garb. So the channel was very scared ki bhai abhi to makeover hua nahi hai, so let us just hide her away. So I was staying in a hotel and in and out from the shoot and no idea. So this was my first appearance in Delhi. And the channel guys kept telling me ki Mona dhyan rakhna, you know, don't worry, we are with you. To mujhe laga pata nahi why are they saying this. I'm fine. So I went to Delhi and we went to a mall. I'm forgetting the name of the mall. It's one of the oldest malls. And the minute I got there, the stage was not very big. And I saw people falling from the escalator, people breaking the stage and creating a chaos. The bodyguards who were with me were thrown apart. Mere jatti ka kurta yahan se phat gaya. I was like, oh my God. And I started to cry. And people were like, Jasti, we want to touch you. We want to feel you. I was like, oh God, what is happening? So somehow the channel guys managed to make me sit in the car and we couldn't move the car for 10 minutes because there were people climbing over it. And I called my dad and मैं इन्हीं घबरा गई थी and I was crying and I didn't know what was happening. So I told papa, I said, papa, मैं तो इतनी कार से फंसी हुई हूँ, but I just want to tell you, तोड़ी बेटी स्टार बन गई है. And my dad was like, beta, we told you that the show is a hit. I was like, no, I'm experiencing it right now in front of my eyes.
Wow.
It was overwhelming. That was the point I realized कि भाई ये तो छोटी बात नहीं है.
So did you ever feel that any other show that you did could match up to that level?
No. You know, which is why it was a conscious decision to stay away from Daily Soap right after Jassi got over. Mm-hmm. And I did Jhalak Dikhla Ja. Mm-hmm. So I participated, I won, then I hosted. I took up a lot of shows where I, you know, got to host. So mm-hmm. I wanted people to see the real me.
Hmm.
You know, break the image and then come back on TV and do something else.
Right.
But Jassi will always remain, you know, my first love, which gave me everything.
I'm sure it did. Okay, so dealing with uncalled for situations, how do you do that? You know, there are a lot of controversies that spring up. There are a lot of negativity. You know, there's a lot of negative publicity these days that makes headlines. So if something comes to you that's really not expected out of the blue, how do you deal with it?
It's a news for one day and then you have to let it go.
Hmm.
The paper goes in the bin the next day.
So,
so I really don't
care.
I mean,
in your
earlier family. I used to get very emotional and sad ki are bhai, what is this?
Hmm.
But now I don't. It doesn't matter. Even people, you know, who troll you unnecessarily on social media and write silly comments and dirty comments,
mm-hmm.
I really don't care. I block them, I delete the comments and I move on.
Mm-hmm.
Because I just feel they're such losers who have done nothing in life and waiting for, you know, waiting to bring someone else down who's doing well and who's happy.
True.
So I don't let it bother me.
Mm-hmm. So how about the projects that you're doing right now? You know, you've just shot for your schedule for Lal Singh Chadda also in Chandigarh and we saw you visiting the Bar Sub as well. So how was the experience like? I mean, the team you've met after 10 years and I know that you got a call from Aamir Khan for the show, for the film. So the whole association getting back and shooting in Chandigarh, your birthplace, how was it like?
Yeah, Chandigarh is not my birthplace.
It is not. It is everywhere.
No.
It is written.
Okay. I know. I don't know how did that come out. I was born in Pune when dad was in the army and he was posted there.
All right.
Yeah.
You were not born in Chandigarh, but still, how was it like?
I still have 3 more days to go and I think I will be shooting in April and then I will be wrapping up my schedule for Lal Singh Chadda. It's been magical for me, the whole journey, the whole experience of, you know, working with Aamir sir again, seeing the magic happening on set again.
Mm-hmm.
And our director, he's beautiful. So he just comes and tells you subtly, Mona, you do whatever you have to, you follow your gut. If I feel you're going wrong, I'll come to you.
Mm-hmm.
And Aamir sir is also like that, you know, I had so many scenes with him and kabhi kabar ek take mein, you know, he used to say, mil gaya. हो गया मिल गया. I'm like, really? And then we used to go and see and he's like, देखा मोना, मैंने कहा था ना मिल गया. I was like, yes.
So is he a real perfectionist as much as he's talked about?
He is. But you know, eventually we all are actors who are emotional people who invest a lot. And Aamir sir is like that. I remember when we first met with all the actors for our reading for Lal Singh Chadda, Aamir sir, while reading his dialogue, started crying. And I realized that he is so emotionally involved in every script that he's a part of.
Right.
And you know, that is the best part about an actor.
Mm-hmm.
Like even during some of my emotional scenes, I used to get back that emotion home.
Mm-hmm.
And then I used to feel miserable. I used to only keep listening to sad songs and cry a little more.
Mm-hmm.
But then I realized it is very important to switch off, you know.
True.
So we have to do that. And working in Lal Singh Chadda has been the most beautiful experience of my life. The entire crew is so beautiful. Our outdoor was for almost 40 days. We were in Amritsar and Chandigarh and in Delhi.
Mm-hmm.
We had a blast in the hotel, shooting together. And during lockdown, we were almost like 50 people who made a Ludo group.
Oh,
and
wow.
We used to play Ludo every night.
That's wonderful. So the kind of foodie you are, could you resist eating all those things in Amritsar? I mean, there's a great variety of food over there. So could you resist yourself?
Well, I was eating a little, cheating a little, but also working out, so I was balancing it out in that way.
So how do you guys maintain the secrecy on the set, you know, because you guys being big stars, you know, all of you who are working on the sets, and there is this whole, you know, bunch of people who are fans. So how do you keep your secrecy intact?
So, when we reach on set, not even on set, on the premises of the location where the vanity vans are packed, there is this bodyguard there with a huge trunk who takes everybody's mobile phones. Everyone, all actors, big, small, character, whoever, everyone's phone goes into that trunk, and nobody can shoot any video or click any pictures for secrecy. And then you go to the set, which is a kilometer away, where the fans are not even allowed. So that is how they maintain secrecy. And only during lunch break we used to get our phone back and we used to call our family, "Hello, हाँ छूट गया."
So during that shoot, you know, because Punjab is known to be a land of flamboyant politicians who like all the attention and everything. So did you ever get a call saying, "Mona ji, ne naal photo khichwani hai, zara 5 minute le thalle bula."
It did happen in the hotel where we were. I got a call from the reception and they said, "Ma'am, there is someone down to meet you, and they're saying they're so and so people's family and la la la. So would you oblige?" So I said, "Dekho, aisa hai ki agar aaj kar diya na, it is going to happen every day." And we used to leave in the morning, not even morning, it was an ungodly hour. We used to leave at 3:30 in the morning for shoot to reach the location Roper at 5 a.m. and then start shooting at 6:37. So by the time we used to come back, we used to be dead tired.
I'm sure.
So I graciously refused, and I was not feeling so good about it, but still it kind of made me feel happy ki something that you don't want to do, don't say yes. It's good to say no.
Don't you get these nasty messages in your inbox saying "Fukri ji, aani sakdi si 5 minute," you know, type?
I'm sure they must have said it, but I never got those messages.
And on that note, Mona, okay, the last question. Punjabi films and Punjabi culture. So have you been getting any offers for Punjabi films or Punjabi songs, as everybody is getting into Punjabi songs these days, or everybody wants to make it big through Punjabi songs? I don't know how, but
But I'll tell you, Punjabi songs are evergreen. They, wherever you are and whichever kind of party, high society, low caste, religion, doesn't matter. It is Punjabi music that gets people to dance. And I remember when I was shooting for Jassi and many other shows, I used to keep getting offers to be a part of Punjabi film, and somehow dates always clashed, always. And my dad used to tell me ki mainu badi khushi hoegi je tu Punjabi picture karegi.
So anything of late, because now the cinema is at a very different level altogether.
Yes, well, nothing I've been offered lately, but agar kuch aayega changa, which is challenging and good to do, I would definitely do it.
Because you are one of those actresses who can speak in Punjabi very well. You don't really need a dubber.
I've hosted PTC Punjabi Live so many times.
हाँ, so there you go. इतने तो बड़ा ही बुरा हाल होता है. So so what all songs are you listening to at the moment? Any favorite Punjabi singers?
Oh my God, that's a tough question. I've been only listening to remixes जिधर भी थोड़ा थोड़ा पंजाबी आ जाती है.
अच्छा ठीक है, that's a very nice and diplomatic answer. Projects and projects that you would want to talk about.
Upcoming project is definitely this one that I'm shooting for, but sorry, I can't talk about it only.
It's
I
okay.
think after a month or two, the channel will be talking about it, and we all will know what it is. Other than that, Lal Singh Chaddha is ready for release. I mean, will be ready for release in December, and I'm eagerly waiting for that.
I swear, है ना, फिल्मा खुलन थोड़ी है जी, हाँ, सिनेमा
हाँ,
में
सच्ची खुल रहे हैं, ऐसे जाएं थिएटर, पता नहीं की सियापा प्यार
थैंक यू मोना, एंड डू पास
थैंक यू
ऑन टू
बोलिए.
श्याम एज वेल, एंड इट वाज अ प्लेजर हैविंग यू टुडे ऑन कैमरा.
थैंक यू, टेक
थैंक यू फॉर
केयर,
बीइंग विद अस. बाय बाय. थैंक यू.
बाय, सत श्री अकाल.
सत श्री अकाल.